the dairy sector has emerged as a vital source of subsidiary income to small and marginal farmers. The dairy sector, by substantially boosting farmers' income, has not only significantly contributed to India's agricultural GDP, but has also made India the world's largest milk producer. India contributes 18.5% of the global production by producing 146 million tons of milk. And all the credit for putting India on the world map goes to one man, Dr. Verghese Kurien. Also known as the Milkman of India, Dr. Kurien launched the Operation Flood program in 1970. Through this program, he formed a national milk grid, linking milk producers throughout India with consumers. And that indeed was a game changer. The White Revolution has indeed transformed the lives of farmers in India forever. The stated objective of Operation Flood was to reduce seasonal and regional price variations while ensuring that the producer gets fair market prices in a transparent manner on a regular basis. From the outset, Operation Flood was conceived and implemented as much more than a dairy program. Rather, dairying was seen as an instrument of development, generating employment and regular income for millions of rural people.
As far as the socio-economic improvement in the farmers is concerned, you see, the entire cooperative model which Amul started in 1947 is only to bring about the economic independence of the to the farmers, because the farmers were getting exploited and they were not getting paid for their produce, particularly milk, and they were getting exploited by the middlemen. So we went into starting up the cooperative movement and cutting down all the middlemen from the system and directly getting milk from the farmers.
Well, Dr. Kurien's vision has changed the fortunes of India's dairy sector. While at one level it has boosted the farmers' income, on the flip side there remained huge challenges in terms of milk storage and its transportation. Lack of cold chain infrastructure resulted in milk getting spoiled and farmers incurring huge losses.
India is the largest milk producing country in the world. At the same time, we also have a number of problems, particularly related to logistics, infrastructure and transportation. And because of that, we are not able to get the milk what we produce at the farm gate level into the dairy plant, and thereby we are incurring the losses almost as on today, I would say something like 4 to 6%. It's like any other agricultural commodity. By the time it reaches to the dairy plant, there has been a tremendous loss of milk in terms of sourage and curd and other things.
To find a way out, Amul enlisted the services of Danfoss India. This renowned global giant promptly offered cooling solutions to Amul's Anand facility, and the result is for all to see.
When we started working with Amul, our journey started in 1992 when the first BMCs were introduced. And a BMC is a bulk milk cooler, where in collection centers, when milk was being collected from farmers, our intention was to see how to keep it, bring down the temperature from 15 degrees to 4 degrees. That was the first intention. And keeping it at that 4 degrees right up the time when the milk can be collected from the collection center right up to the dairy. So our intention was to provide a reliable condensing unit that not only helped them to bring the temperature down, but would also be efficient. So that is how we started our journey with Amul. Today we have made a lot of progress, because in Amul, in the dairies, we offer a number of components which provides automation, energy efficiency. We also offer the variable frequency drives at these dairies. We need to understand that cold chain is about adding a bit of cost to the product, and we cannot prevent that from happening. But how can we make it more energy efficient is what we look at.
Well, apart from providing energy efficient solutions, Danfoss equipment also helps reduce loss of milk at the farm gate levels with its faster cooling systems, and which in turn has increased the farmer's income.
When we didn't have any bulk chilling units at the society level, We were getting milk in unchilled condition in cans at a dairy plant. So by the time milk reaches, it is almost, I would say, something like, you know, 3 to 5%, you know, the loss. We get about 1,000 liters of milk, and 5% milk would get lost, or it gets curdled or spoiled by the time it reaches to the dairy plant. So there, when we went for installation of the bulk chilling unit with the Danfoss equipments and the compressors, the spoilage has almost come down to zero. I would say that there is absolutely no spoilage, because we are able to chill the milk in time. And the other thing, as far as the direct benefit to the farmers is concerned, is number one, it reduces the milk temperature within an hour or two, okay, from by the time you pour into the tank. So there is a tremendous amount of the saving one. And number two, you know, the Danfoss compressor needs only 3.5 kilo of the refrigerant, as compared to the conventional ones, which we are also having, that's about 7 kilo. A direct saving of something like 1400 or 1500 rupees per life cycle. So that is a saving to the farmer, number one. And number two is that, you know, since the chilling is so efficient, and we are paying milk based on the quality of microbiology, bacteriological quality, and we are paying about something like 5 paise per liter of milk, so it controls the bacterial growth. The farmer gets 5 paise additional for his every liter of milk what he gives to the society. The other benefit is that, you know, it requires very less maintenance, and it does not, the operational cost is less. I would say something like we just, did a calculation, what is the Danfoss compressors and the normal compressor. It's something like, 17% is the maintenance cost which goes down at the society level. And when I say 17% maintenance cost, in the sense, that is a huge savings as far as the farmer is concerned.
All in all, the condensing units equipped with Danfoss components, variable frequency drives, Optima Slim Pack with microchannel heat exchanger and controls has led to significant savings for Amul, besides reducing spoilage losses to almost zero levels. Clearly, the white revolution has put India's dairy sector on the global map.